God bless you. So we'd like to take our reading this morning from the book of Luke, chapter 14, and from verse 27. As the Bible says, "And whosoever doeth not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. For which of you intending to build a tower, setteth not down first and count the cost, whether he have sufficient to finish it?" Amen. I'd like to title this morning devotion, amen, counting the cost, amen. Shall we pray? Gracious God and eternal Father, Lord, we love you. Lord, we appreciate you. Father, we know your word is already blessed, Lord, but won't you bless it to our hearts, Father? Speak to us, Lord, whatever this day may bring, oh God, lead us, guide us, Father. We commit all things in your name, Lord, in Jesus Christ, we pray and ask. Amen. Even as the scripture says, amen, whosoever doeth not obey his cross. This morning, I want to encourage you, friends. Are you willing to bear your cross, amen, for Christ, amen? Are you willing to bear it and come after him, amen? Go after him. Walk the road that he has walked, amen. Bear the things that he has bore for us, amen. Even as the scripture tells us, for which of you intending to build a tower, if you're intending to start a project or build something, amen, we first sit down and count the cost, whether we have sufficient, amen. And this morning, amen, what is the cost of our life, amen? What is the cost of this gospel, amen? What is our price that we're willing, amen, to lay down for? Even as in Matthew 19, the Bible speaks of the rich young ruler coming before Jesus. And he says, "Behold, one came unto him and said unto him, Good master, what good thing shall I do?" And a title or a context for this morning devotion is, "What good thing shall I do?" Amen. Every one of us want to know, amen, or have a question. What good thing shall we do? Amen. What shall we do to find a favor from God? Amen. Some of us want favor from our boss, or some of us want favor from our teachers, our colleagues, our spouses, our children, amen. But I think this morning the most important thing is to find favor with the Lord, amen. And even as this man came, the rich young ruler came with a good desire, he came before Christ, amen, and saying, "Good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?" And Jesus answered and said unto him, "Why callest me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep thy commandments." And he said unto him, Jesus began to tell him the commandments. He said, "But thus have I kept from my young man up," amen. So he was a good man, so to speak. And then Jesus tells him, amen, he says unto him, "Sell all that thine have." Just sell all that thine have and give to the poor, that thou shalt have treasure in heaven, and come follow me. But when the young man heard that saying, he went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions, amen. His cost was too much, amen. The cost of his earthly possessions, he was not willing to lay down. Even as the Bible tells us, amen, that God was, Christ was not seeking after his possession, but he was dealing with his heart, amen. It was a heart condition that he was dealing with. Even as we see in the book of 1 Samuel, amen, when God sends the prophet Samuel to anoint David king, and he said unto him, "But the Lord said unto Samuel, Look not unto his countenance, or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth. For the man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart." Amen. I wonder how, if we have to take cost, if we have to take an account this morning of our life and our heart, amen, or how, if the Lord looks at our heart this morning, what will he see, amen? What's the treasure of our heart this morning? What is the cost, amen? Even as the Bible tells us, amen, "For what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and he loses his own soul?" Amen. What price can we put on the soul of a man? Amen. Some people will go to the ends of the earth to accumulate the most precious jewels, to accumulate the most precious possessions. Amen. But once you have attained that, what more? Amen. All these things will come to naught. All these things, the riches of this world, will perish. Amen. For what shall it profit a man if he gains his whole world and loses his own soul? Even as in Matthew 6:21, it tells us, for where your treasure is, there your heart. Even as the Amplified Version says, for where your treasure is, there your heart is. Your wishes, your desires, that are on which your life centers. Amen. Which will be also. So where is our life centered this morning? Amen. Is it centered on Christ this morning? Or is it centered on the possessions of this world? Or is it centered around our children or our spouses? Amen. Remember, man will fail us, but God never fails us. Amen. We know that the ultimate price that Christ has paid this morning, he has given all freely, amen, freely for you and I, amen, that we might have eternal life. We cannot put a price, amen, on eternal life, amen. Even as Spurgeon says, amen, true Christianity will cost a man the favor of the world. He must be content to be thought ill of by the rest of the world if he pleases God. He must count it at no strange thing to be mocked, ridiculed, slandered, persecuted, or even hated. Amen. You know, when Christ paid the price, amen, when he cried, it is finished, amen. It was finished. The debt has been settled. The price has been paid, amen. Our healing has been atoned for, amen. We know that when he said, when he paid the price on Calvary, the blood was on the mercy seat for you and I this morning. The blood was on the lintel, on the doorpost. But the life of the blood needs to come in us and live within us, amen, that we might be able to be like Christ and do the things that he has done, amen, walk the walk that he has walked, amen. Even as a prophet of God, he says, amen, he says, now the same thing is this: if you are a son of God, if I'm a son of God or a daughter of God, we were in God at the beginning. And when Jesus became the fullness of the word, then we were with him in germ form. When he was crucified, we was crucified in his body. When he rose from the dead, we rose with him. He says, now since we have recognized it, now we sit together with him in heavenly places. He says, if we are sons and daughters of God, we are God's children. Then we are the attributes of God. We got eternal life. And God is the only eternal life that he is. Then we were in him from the beginning. And when Jesus became all that word, we were part of him. And he says, there's no devil, no powers, no nothing ever can move it. That's the typos of the soul this morning. That's the typos. No devil can move us this morning. No powers, no nothing can move it, amen. Because we are anchored to Christ. We stand before a defeated devil, amen. We stand before a defeated enemy, amen. Because remember, Christ has conquered it already for us. But now we've got to recognize what he has done for us, amen. Even as the prophet of God in Ephesian church age, amen, he says, no matter how just and upright a Christian is before the public, how gracious he is to his fellow men, doing naught but good, let him confess Christ as his Savior and acknowledge the operations of the gifts of the Holy Spirit in prophecy, in tongues, healings, and miracles, he will be condemned. The spirit of this world hates the Spirit of God, because it can't overcome the Spirit of the Lord. It tries to destroy the vessel in whom the Spirit of truth dwells in. Persecutions and trials are natural, normal part of a Christian life. There is only one thing you can do about them. Commit them all to God. He says, judge not, and leave their outworking and final judgment to him this morning. So friends, if we count the cost this morning, amen, What are we willing to sell our soul for, amen? What are we willing to give up this eternal life for? Is it for something of this world, amen? Even as Esau sold his birthright for a bowl of pottage, amen. He thought of the pottage, or his hunger was more of importance than his birthright, amen. What is our cost this morning? What shall it profit a man to gain his whole world but loses his own soul, amen? You know, Christ has been paid for us, amen. This gospel, his salvation is free, but it's not cheap. Billy Graham says, amen. It has been paid by the blood of Jesus, amen. God has paid it all for us on the cross of Calvary. But religion will leave him there. But now the blood has to come alive in us, amen. The life of the blood got to come into us, amen. We got to be washed by the washing of the word, amen. God bless you.